Hello, welcome back. So now we will see what are the design stress strain curve for concrete that we will be using in this design method. So first we will see the actual stress strain curve of concrete, and the same curve we have seen in the previous course also. So in this case, you can see this is the actual typical stress strain curve for concrete. So or to C it is linear, and then C to A it becomes a little parabolic, and then A to B it is now declining. Now this is the actual curve. Now in that case, in case of limit state design, we have idealized this curve to this one. Now in this case, maximum strength of curve, say this curve is for M25 grade of concrete, and 25 Newton is occurring at point A, and the strain corresponding to point A is 0.2. So generally we have idealized the curve. I mean, we have just considered the strength of curve up to this point, and we have taken extended strain for the concrete, and that becomes our idealized curve. So you can see here 0.67 FCK is the actual strength, and which we get, I mean, the curve corresponding to this strength is the characteristic curve, which is showing the characteristic strength. Similarly, now because we are supposed to find out design strength, and design strength is actually the fraction of this strength. So once we divide 0.67 FCK by the safety factor. Now safety factor I have shown you in the previous slide. And there the safety factor for concrete is 1.5. So dividing this value, we get 0.447 FCK. So this is the design strength. And corresponding to this design strength, we have this idealized strength curve. So basically, this much strength is basically the reserve strength. So in our design, we will be using only this much strength of concrete, which is around 45% of the actual strength. Okay, so, and the maximum permissible strain in the concrete is 0.0035. Okay, so this is the idealized curve that we will be using in our design, and all the formula will be based on this curve. So this is the curve of concrete. Now we will see stress strain curve for mild steel and HYSD bar. So first we will see the actual original stress strain curve of mild steel. So I have shown you this in the previous course also. So in that, this is the actual stress strain curve, and B at point B, where I mean, after point B, the yielding of the strength, I mean, yielding of steel starts. So corresponding to point B, we consider that this is the maximum strength of steel, and this is called the yield strength of steel. So this much strength we consider as the maximum strength, which we're representing as Fy. And we know that maximum strength of steel is up to D. So corresponding to D, this is the strength that we generally don't consider in our design. So that is the basically the reserve strength. But strength corresponding to B, we consider only this strength. So now we have idealized this curve, and the idealized curve look like this. So now you can see, corresponding to Fy, this value is 250 Newton per mm square. So we consider only up to this strength, and that is why we have only considered this point, which is Fy. After this, we are not considering this much strength. So curve corresponding to Fy, we consider this as characteristic curve. Similarly, to find out the design strength, we again have to divide Fy by 1.15. So this 1.15 is the safety factor for steel, which we have, I mean, which I have shown you in the previous slide. So dividing this, we get 0.87 Fy. So you can see, we will use strength of steel up to this point. And this is basically the reserve strength. So this is basically the reserve strength. So in our design, we will be considering this is our maximum strength, and we will be designing all the elements based on this strength only. Similarly, in case of concrete, we will be taking maximum strength of concrete as 0.447 FCK. So this is the press strain curve for mild steel. Well, generally in our design, nowadays we don't use mild steel. We use high strength steel, which we call high HYSD bar, high yield strength deformed bar. So first we will see the stress strain curve of high yield strength deformed bar. So you can see here, this is the stress strain curve, which I have shown you in the previous course also. And generally, there is no definite yield point in the stress strain curve of HYSD bar. And therefore, what we do is we draw a parallel line at 0.2% proof stress, proof strain. And corresponding to this, we get the proof stress. So the point where this line is cutting. So at 0.2% strain, we draw a line which will cut this curve at this point, and corresponding to this point, the strength we get is actually the Fy value. So this is the yield strength which we consider by this. So in this case, we consider only curve up to this, while we know that maximum strength of this curve can be up to this, and this is actually the reserve strength which we generally don't consider in our design. So the idealized curve of this stress strain curve look like this. So here also you can see this is the characteristic curve corresponding to Fy, this one. And again, to get the design strength, Fy is divided by 1.15 and we get 0.87 Fy as the design strength. So generally this is our design curve, and we design our elements using this design curve only. And you can see there are some points where different design strength can be calculated using different strain value. So these are generally calculated in case of doubly reinforced beam design. So if we design doubly reinforced beam in case of limit state method, we are required to have some stresses in steel corresponding to different strain. So this curve is used there also. So we will be using this curve for our design purpose. And yes, so this is the design curve for our steel. So these are the topics that we have covered in our this lecture. So we will continue in the next lecture. Thank you.